Hello, good morning. In the last class, we have seen that heat engine. So heat engine is the any practical machine which convert heat into mechanical works. It called the heat engine. So there are ideal heat engine. So Carnot is the French engineer. We are seeing now today's topic is the Carnot's ideal heat engine. So this is the ideal heat engine and its efficiency is 100%. Okay, so in practice there is no any machine which has the efficiency 100%, but efficiency is greater than the ideal engine heat engine. So Carnot discovered this. This is the French engineer. French engineer Sadi Carnot. Sadi Carnot in 1924 discovered this ideal heat engine, and the efficiency of any heat engine cannot be greater than this ideal heat engine. So this ideal heat engine is only exist in means it is the theoretical heat engines, so it is not in actual practice. So that's why this is the Carnot's ideal heat engine. So the diagram of Carnot ideal heat engine is like this. So this is the ideal gas, means gas is filled as a working substance, and there are three main parts. First part is the source of heat. First part. Second part, sink of heat. Third is the heat insulating stand. And third is the piston cylinder assembly. So these are the four main parts of the Carnot's ideal heat engine. First is the source of heat, second is the sink of heat, third is the heat insulating stand, and fourth is the piston cylinder assembly. So these are the main parts of the Carnot's ideal heat engine. So we already know that such engine cannot be realized in practice. So Carnot ideal heat engine cannot be realized in practice, because in real practice some part of it, there is a loss of heat due to the friction and working substance. So in ideal heat engine there is no loss. So this is the word ideal heat engine, because there is a no loss of heat due to friction and working substance when there is expansion or reduction or conduction of heat due to this working substance. So there is no loss of heat. So that's why it is called the ideal heat engine, but it is not exist. Okay, in practice. This cannot be realized in practice, but it has a maximum efficiency. This is only theoretical. Okay, this is only theoretical ideal gas engine. It is not exist or realized in the practice. This is only theoretical. So these are the four main parts: source of heat, sink of heat, heat insulating stand, and piston cylinder assembly. So first is the source of heat. So this part is the source of heat. This is maintained at the high temperature T1. This is the higher temperature, and there is no loss of heat because upper part is only conducting. This is the conducting part and this is the insulating part. Okay, means three sides of this source has an insulating covering. Means there is no transfer of heat from this three sides. There is only transfer of heat from the top. Means top has a conducting. And this is maintained at the higher temperature. Okay, when there is an extraction of heat, there is no change or there is no loss of heat from this. Okay, so that's why this is the insulating stand. Means whenever the heat is extracted from it, the temperature is maintained. Means it has the infinite capacity. It plays as the infinite capacity of heat, T1 degree centigrade, higher temperature. Okay. So this is the first source of heat. Then second is the sink of heat. So this is the sink. So same as the source. So this sink has the three insulating sides. Three sides are insulating. And conducting base, means the top portion of this sink is the conducting only. This is the plane surface, this is the conducting surface, and sink is maintained at the T2 Kelvin, means this is the lowest temperature. Sink is maintained at the lowest temperature. So when there is a addition or given, when the heat is given to sink, that this maintained as the lower temperature, this is the settlement, means sink is maintained, always maintained at the low temperature. Okay, so it is kept at the constant lower temperature. So third is the heat insulating stand. So this is the third portion of the cannon hiding agent in heat insulating stand. Or these four sides of this heat insulating stand is insulating, means there is a no transfer of heat, means heat cannot be transferred from these four sides of the insulating stand. This is the insulating stand. There is no any transferring of heat from sinks to source, source to sinks. So this is kept between the source and the sink, heat in the insulating stand. And last part is the piston cylinder assembly. So this is the piston assembly, piston, and this is the cylinder, this is the assembly. So in that piston cylinder assembly, ideal gas is filled as the working substance. So in working substance means, first of all we are taking the gas heat engine. We are taking gas, there is a ideal gas is filled in that cylinder, and there is a piston. This piston is the frictionless piston, means there is a heat is absorbed from the source, there is expansion or compression of the gas, but there is a no loss of heat. So this piston is the frictionless. So we know that there is a loss of heat due to frictions when the piston is move upward or downward. So this piston is the frictionless. So that's why there is this you see in the diagram. So this piston, is the insulating. Okay, and the two walls of this cylinder has an insulating material, made up of insulating material, or covering with the insulating material. And this lower part means this is the base of this engine. Sorry, base of this cylinder is the conducting, means cylinder has the conducting base. Okay, so this is the diagram of Carnot ideal heat engine. Okay, there are four main parts. Piston cylinder, first is the source of heat. Means source is maintained at the, source has the high capacity, means whenever there is a continuously extraction of heat at a T1 degree, means T1 is the highest temperature. Okay, so this source is maintained at the higher temperature. Second is the sink of heat. Sink is maintained at the lower temperature. It kept at the constant lower temperature. Its capacity is also infinite, so that the temperature, means its capacity is at infinite. Okay, means there is a given of heat, means its temperature remains constant at T2 degree Kelvin, because whenever there is a heat is given off to the sink, so there is an increase in temperature, but there is a no increase because this is maintained at the lower temperature T2. Its capacity is infinity. Say source has also the infinity capacity, means whatever the amount of heat is can be absorbed from the source, it is maintained at the infinite capacity. Then sink is maintained at the lower temperature. When some amount of heat is given off to the sink, there is no increase of temperature. So it has the infinite capacity. Then third is the heat insulating stand. There is no any transfer of heat from the insulating stand, which does not allow heat to pass through it. It is a perfect heat insulating stand. And third one is the piston cylinder assembly. So piston cylinder assembly, cylinder, two sides of cylinder is has made up of insulating material and a piston. Piston has also the frictionless. Okay, so piston is made up of, piston is also non-conducting material which moves without friction in the cylinder. The cylinder contains, and this cylinder contains 1 mole of ideal gas as a working substance. Working substance is filled in the cylinder, and in this ideal heat engine, 1 mole of perfect gas, ideal gas, is filled as a working substance. So this is the construction of Carnot's ideal heat engine. In the last class, we will see the working of this Carnot ideal heat engine. Okay, thank you.